funny, but I don't know why. Scares me while I kiss the sky.
Hello, DC. Dave the Pickup Artist with you this morning. And I am still in my pajamas because I'm taking part in Randy Weaver's, I want to say, push to 500 contest, but I was just on his channel and it looks like he's got 501 subs now. So congrats, Randy. Randy wants to see some morning stuff. What you like to listen to in the morning? First, I got a morning song. We are listening to Morning Dew. This is the Grateful Dead from a Dix Picks CD. Morning Dew. This is the last track that they often use this as an encore. This was a from a Pembroke Pines, Florida show down here in Florida in 1977. And these usually have pretty cool little photos. They're pretty much no frills CDs, but they're very good. They also did a version on their first album, and they probably played the song even before this came out, because they came out in 1963, and it was, I'm not going to take it out, 1963 by Bonnie Dobson. Bonnie Dobson was a Canadian folk singer, and back in 63, everybody was worried about the bomb, and, you know, there were a lot of songs about, you know, kind of protest songs or anti-war songs, and that was the thing back then. And she apparently spent the night writing this song, and she introduced it at a folk festival in 1963. Among the other artists at that folk festival were Gordon Lightfoot, who's also a Canadian singer-songwriter. And but there were other bands that covered it. One of them was the Jeff Beck Band, Truth. This is the first solo.
Come on, man.
Rod Stewart. Morning Dew is the third track on here. Yeah, this is a great album, as you all know. Dwayne and Greg covered it. This is a pre-Allman Brothers album.
Holy Jesus.
That was supposed to be the second album for the 31st of February with another member of the Allman Brothers called...
How's your joint, George?
Butch Trucks, the drummer. But it fell through. But this came out in the early 70s. You know, it's kind of a, I don't know, exploitation album. But yeah, it's pretty good if you want. It's got a very early version of Melissa on it. Another band that covered the song was the West Coast Pop Art Experimental Band. They did something a little different. They changed the name of the song to Will You Walk With Me? And they credited their guitar player for a songwriting credit. So, yeah, kind of underhanded, but I gotta tell you, I've listened to this song about three times and I couldn't really tell it was Morning Dew. It's so weird. This band is so weird, you can't even really tell. And finally, I've got an album that I think is a great morning album. It starts off kind of acoustic and kind of a southern rock, classic rock vibe. Barnstorm, Get Wild. And on side two, we've got Bird Call Morning. Starts it off. Very laid back, kind of country. Then we get to the big one, Turn to Stone, which is my favorite Joe Walsh song. Then it starts rocking. And yeah, that's it. Congratulations, Randy. And you, it won't be long till you're 1,000 subs. So take care.